Hi guys, so if you're new here, or if you're not, if you want to hear me voice act, head over to our main channel, links down below, and if you don't, this channel's solely for TTS. If you want to know all the details about what's going on, we have a stream up that you can go and watch, but let's just get into the video.
Mama's Finest is the kind of family restaurant that one would go if you were one short on unions to have a huge family to feed, which goes well with number one. 3 looking for a place to hire you despite being a poor as fuck orc or troll. The place was created by an orc mother who came up with recipes to feed her ever increasing family and didn't shy away from hiring mothers in need of cash or ex-trog convicts. All it serves is soul food, junk food and whatever can be fried and or powdered with synthetic sugar. The forerunners, like they are used to, decided to meet their Johnson in advance. They started to like looking professional and taking jobs early and finishing them earlier than expected. Plus they have a need of urgency since the end of the month was coming, along with paying the rent. Dice, so who's our Johnson? Short fuse, dunno, Hope was told our client would be eating fish by this hour. Bite, ain't helping much in a restaurant, no? Wolfhound, I've heard their fish sticks are horrible, barely anyone order them. We could check who's having some? Bite. Oh yeah, nice one. Excuse me sir, may I look at what's on your plate? I want to verify if you're my client or not, may I look into your soda can while I'm at it? Wolfhound, you got anything better smartus? Bite. As a matter of fact, I do. Bite then went on a counter and plugged his Cyberdeck and jacked in. No employees bothered to look at the decker, since they were overwhelmed by clients. Then 5 minutes later, the hacker left his stool and met up with his gang. There was also a suspicious amount of electronics that started malfunctioning. The team didn't miss on the mischievous glee their albino friend had. Bite. Well, no one ordered anything fish related since at least a week ago. Dice. So we'll have to wait for our client then? Short fuse. Seems like it. Bite. You two are pretty daft, no? Dice. Hey. Short fuse, what do you mean? Wolfhound, he means the client is surely eating the fish that gets thrown into the thrash. Bite, which means he's a broke fuck, and he ain't got money for us. Let's leave. The decker didn't have the time to make a step before the Sammy put his hand on his shoulder. Wolfhound, look pal, we already butchered a job once, and we got lucky. Let's not test our luck, shall we? Bite, exasperated. They went to the alleyway alongside the family restaurant. There was a ton of thrash pile waiting laying around. Either the place wastes too much food, or the garbage men were on strike. The alley was empty except for a stray cat meowing at the back door of Mama's Finest. The hacker, being not in the mood, decided to kick the stray cat to make it leave. Ow. You fucking filthy who. Bite. What the fuck? To everyone's surprise, their client was a talking cat. It had a female voice and was plenty pissed at Bite for kicking her. Her fur was black and she had 2 tails and her eyes were glowing blue. MRS Johnson, what kind of freak abuses an animal? Bite, look, I'm so. MRS Johnson, you dumb fuck. Inbred asshole. Useless breeder. Bite, I'm sorry. There I said it. MRS Johnson, you don't look sorry you moronic baboon. Short fuse, please, MRS Johnson. You have to forgive our friend here, he's. Wolfhound, retarded. Bite, wah. Dice, and he's a mature. Bite, would you all shut up already? The feline seemed a little pleased that the Shadowrunners were joining on insulting the Deckers. She jumped up a thrash can so she could look the group in the eyes easier. MRS Johnson, well I'd be inclined to cut your pay for kicking me. But I don't need money. Plus my offer is all or nothing. Short fuse, so how much are we talking about MRS Johnson? MRS Johnson. 20,000 nullions, plus maybe 4,000 in gears. That should be the reward I think. Short fuse, you think? MRS Johnson, I'm a cat, numbers ain't my thing. Counting's a biped's job. Bite, we're going to get fuck in the ass, mark my words. Short fuse, my friend's not totally wrong for worrying, but let's the job first. What do you want us to do? MRS Johnson, my owner got murdered. He was part of the Accusus, and I want you to exterminate the ones who killed him. Short fuse, seems simple enough. Do you have any idea who did him in? MRS Johnson, they were Yakuza's too. I memorize their smell. I can track them. Take me with you where my owner used to live. Since the Raz Roadmaster was still in repair, they couldn't ride to MRS Johnson's home in their sweet van. On the plus side, the apartment wasn't far from Mama's Finest. The runners assumed the cat went to the restaurant every day. Inside MRS Johnson's apartment was a total mess. Furnitures were in pieces. Dust and filth was covering most of the floor, except for a spot where a pool of blood used to be. That, along with a silhouette traced with chalk. There were burned marks, along with scratch from human nails around where was the body. Bite. Nasty way to go. Dice. Uneased. How? How did he died? Wolfhound. Wild guess. He was burned partly, or electrocuted, whatever was more painful. Bite. Then judging the bloodstains. Wolfhound, the cut was made so it would take a dreck load of time before death, conscious with the pain. Dice, I feel sick. Short fuse, didn't you turn a dude into chunky salsa not long ago? Dice, it's not the same thing. He was already dead when it happened. I'm not like that. Bite, keep telling yourself that, lil psycho. The Decker looked around a little, he was perplexed. As if there was a specific thing he was looking for. Short fuse, what are you doing, Bite? Bite, I'm curious, why was your bloke killed, cat? MRS Johnson, I'm not sure, it was something about taking what's theirs and stealing from the family. Bite, and yet you still have something to offer after they ransacked the place? The cat didn't say a word, she only stared at the Decker with intense hatred. Her eyes glowing a spectral blue were almost chilling the room. Dice, you mean she ain't going to pay us? Bite, either that or the loot's pretty well hidden. When was the murder? MRS Johnson was infuriated, yet silent. Bite, come on, don't be like that. It's to help you after all. MRS Johnson, there is no use telling you when it happened, you ape. I can track the murderers, and I want them dead now. Bite, either you answer, or we'll walk out of here. Short fuse, wait, you can't decide that on your own. Bite, you have no right to talk, it's a bloody magical cat and you've not even sensed it. Short fuse was about to retort with an insult, but he stopped in his tracks when he realized how justified Bite was with his comment. MRS Johnson, he died a week ago. Bite, and they haven't found the cash? MRS Johnson, no. They haven't. Bite, so what's the guarantee they haven't found the stash yet? The cat only looked at the Decker with a glare only reserved for filth. Then without saying a word she began scratching a part of the floor. Beneath the floor was hidden an old safe, like the one you find in old gangster trids or dropping on someone's head in cartoons. MRS Johnson, it's there. I'm afraid they have the key to it though. Bite, so, why haven't the Yaks found the safe yet? They won't give up if they've got the key, no? MRS Johnson, I can be distracting. Now we're heading towards the murderers. Now. They left the apartment, but not before the dwarf sensed the cat. It was a magic critter alright, but there was something strange about its aura. Like it was awfully bland for a para critter. They followed the cat towards an old warehouse in the downtown parts of Seattle. Inside were over two dozens Yakuza's. Plus two attack dogs. Wolfhound tensed up when he saw the dogs. For a second his teammates feared that he would chicken out of the fight, but the Sammy clenched his fist and simply asked the infiltrator and the mage a favor. I would like to say what followed was the fight of our lives, that us 4 against 25 were the hardest we ever encountered, but truth be told, it was trivial. Inside the warehouse were 25 Japs, armed and dangerous. Among them was Kintaro Sato and his brother Akira. Never in their life have they faced a person they couldn't take down. Never before did anyone offer any kind of resistance to them. It hasn't always been easy since they joined the Yakuza's, but they couldn't imagine now living without its benefits. Once again, Quintero was admiring the new Chrome he installed with the savings he managed to get during the last year. His arm was bright blue and orange and projected flames in R. Not only he is super strong with it, but he could wield his katana like a badass like in the movies he watched. His older brother wasn't approving of his choice to chrome up, but he can suck a dick when it will be the young lad that gets rep for wrecking other gangs. It has been a few days, him and his gang has been locked up in the warehouse. Apparently the dude they murdered had some dirt on them, and they haven't got it back yet. Seems like the higher ups won't let them do anything until the issue has been dealt with. He wasn't complaining much. He likes to prove his worth in a fight, but hates even more putting his life at risk. Quintero was about to ask the guy on the left for a bisset calf when he noticed the man wasn't there at all. Now that he looks closely, weren't there like 25 guys in there? Including the boss? There are like 5 people missing. Did they went to grab something? They know they should wait for the boss's orders before going outside. Speaking of him, he seems on edge for some reason. Quintero, wait, the dogs. They're growling. They're barking at me. Why are they? Instinctively, he managed to dodge incoming claws aimed at his throat. Well, he guessed those were claws by the marks they left on the wall behind him, but he couldn't see who attacked him. Shit, it's invisible. He only had the time to yell this before grenades filled with gas exploded in the center of the room. He was on his knees, having a hard time to breath. His eyes, throat and nostrils were burning as if they were on fire. He couldn't make a noise except for coughing like a madman. Most of his fellow gang members were in a similar state. It was a massacre. Akira was still standing and trying to bark orders at the other crooks, but he was clearly about to succumb to the pepper gas grenades. It would have been useless anyway, they were dropping like flies. They went from over 20 men to less than 10 in the first minute. 5 have been gutted like fishes, and another 5 went unconscious from the red smoke. There's also a few guys missing. Like the boss. He drew his Raz Predator, but there was no target in sight. His brother said that the opponent was invisible, so there's surely a mage involved. But the attack is too well planned. Surely it's not just one person, and if it's truly the case, running outside would be suicide. Akira was about to grab his brother and find cover behind some crates when the dogs jumped towards him. He raised his weapon thinking they went mad, but he found himself surprised when the two canines were biting the air. Wolfhound, oh god, no, they're on me. Fuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuu down. Whoever said that was probably right. King Terror went down like a sack of rice, and they lost more than half of the guys. Even him felt like he was about to fall unconscious in the next 10 seconds. Well, if he's going down, he's not doing it without putting a fight. With his Raz Predator, he shot once to where he estimated the attacker was, and despite his burning and blurry vision, he aimed well enough. Wolfhound, ugh. Fuck me, right next to the balls. Bite, can't believe our top dog nearly got himself operated. Bite then made a scissor gesture while grinning like an absolute bastard towards Wolfhound. The latter made a gesture of his own with his middle finger. Short fuse, so would that be all, MRS Johnson? We took them down like you ask. MRS Johnson, I ask to exterminate them. I see that some apes are still breathing. Dice, aim, that's a little overkill, miss? Wolfhound, we ain't paid to question the client, Dice. Bite, and beside, they went overkill on Fleabag's owner. Don't do to others what you don't expect could happen to you. The cat turned its head towards the hacker. If looks can kill, he would be turned into a red paste on the warehouse's floor. MRS Johnson, I pay for all of them dead, and there's one missing here. Dice, who's that? That would be me. Above them on the warehouse's roof was the boss of the Yakuza group. He was tall, wearing a metal armor and sporting a cybernetic arm and eyes, as well as some other gears. Colon, my name is Inoue Nori, also known as Cocktail for street rats like yourselves. Now I wonder, did you really think you could take me down with some second-rate gas grenades? Everyone was on their guard against the Yakuza leader's next move. Everyone, except Dice. She recognizes that name. It was one of the first on her list, the one she tried to find out through the troll during the night she joined the team. Cocktail, I applaud your vain attempt at my life, but you will find that I have countermeasures against such flimsy tactics. As soon as he said that, he threw some gas grenades of his own on the ground. After a few moments passed, the crooks who have been knocked out begin to stand up, but with foam coming out of their mouths and bloodshot eyes. Whatever was in them, it turned them berserk. Oh, the dogs were up too, to Wolfhound's dismay. Cocktail, I wish you good luck against them. Even I doubt that a bullet through the head would put a stop to them once they have tasted my special medicine. Dice, not so fast in no way. Dice wasn't about to let her target get away after spending so much time tracking it. Especially now that she has found him through sheer luck, she wasn't going to let him escape no matter what. With her grappling hook she reached the warehouse's roof in an instant. Cocktail, who are you pipsqueak, to dare challenge me? Dice, I am Pepper Allen. Apprentice of Deadline, the world's greatest assassin. And I challenge you to an honorable duel to the death for my survival. Cocktail, another one, huh? I am not interested in his antics, not anymore. Dice, wait, what if? The infiltrator didn't get the time to finish her sentence that she received a kick to the stomach. A pretty solid one too. Unbeknownst to her, her opponent shot himself with some drugs to boost his performance. So strong was his strike that the young girl was barely able to stop herself from falling through a window and land into the pile of crackhead accusers. Cocktail, perhaps after I finish you I will finally be done with him. Wolfhound, I wouldn't count on it, pal. No tabletop RPG is complete without beautiful models on the table, and the best place to get models is from us. If you check the link below, we have everything you could need for your magical realm. Only the finest of big titty wafers here. But if you're not into models or don't play with models, we got you covered with subclasses such as the Gachimashi Wizards, the Simp Warlock and the North FC Fighter. Also, we have started selling 5th edition adventures, with our first one featuring Belle Delphine, the succubus that has poisoned the town's well and turned the villagers into simps. If any of that stuff sounds fun to you, go ahead and check the link below, but let's get back to the video. Instead of taking on 10-15 dope Japanese gangsters and dogs, the group decided to take care of the accuser boss instead. Wellbite wanted to bail, but being grabbed by Wolfhound and flying through the air with his rocket feet and a levitate spell change a man's mind. Cocktail, who at first was confident of his chances against Dice, now was doubting if he could make it out alive. Also, the group forgot to take their client with them, and now the cat was alone right in front of a group of bloodthirsty madmen and beasts. Now they would have regretted doing this, if it was not that MRS Johnson's eyes began to glow blue in a cold fashion, and suddenly the corpses of two mutilated mobsters rose up. Their skin was pale, and their limbs stretched. They barely looked human anymore. Everyone on the rooftop was collectively surprised at the sight of genuine zombies. Well, everyone but Wolfhound, who kept his eyes on Cocktail, and Short Fuse, who took an astral look at the phenomenon and saw some transparent jellyfishes puppeteering the bodies. He wondered what kind of spirit those were. Cocktail, I can't believe it. You idiots brought a Bacchanico with you. Short Fuse, I'm sorry to say this, but you've brought this upon yourself. Wolfhound, well, as long as it take care of your punks, I don't mind if it's a dragon in a pink clown suit. Cocktail, you cretins, those are vicious monsters. They are to be destroyed, otherwise it would spell doom for us. Bite, I wouldn't count on it, dipshit. Cocktail, and why is that? Dice, because we intend to take you down, right here, right now. Bite, and you won't live to see it happen. Inoue Nori knew that he wouldn't be able to survive this encounter. In fact, it is quite likely that with the four of them surrounding him, he wouldn't be able to put up much of a fight. If he's about to die, so be it. Those punks will regret facing him. Cocktail, the master of chemicals, the one acknowledged by Deadline so long ago. Before any of his enemies had time to act, he injected himself with a mix of many different combat drugs. He could feel his muscles bulging, his skin tear under the pressure at some places, his bones creaking at the strength he now disposes and the uncontrollable rage that inhabits him. With a bestial roar, he jumped towards the first person in front of him, which happened to be Bite. The hacker would have been history if it were not for Wolfhound and Dice interfering, the former with his retractable claws firmly planted in the accuser's ribs, and the latter with her monofilament whip restraining his non-cyber arm. But those were not enough. He still managed to punch the Decker. While a solid blow to the chest, it didn't took him out immediately. Short Fuse was panicking and didn't know what he should do, so he casted Control Thought on the enraged man and forced him to hit as hard as he can repeatedly with his metallic arm. To his own nuts. While quite amusing, it was far from enough to put an end to this monster. While the runners were fighting Japanese Bane, another kind of fight was happening downstairs. The Bakaniko had no worries that she could take on the rampaging apes that stood in front of her, that is if only she had the time and resources for greater spells. The two minions that she summoned were barely holding off against the onslaught. And by barely, what it means is that they could take on a beating very well, but overwhelmed by numbers as they were, they couldn't reciprocate in kind to the punishments. Even worse, they have been taken down once or twice already, and in order to sustain themselves they would need fresh bodies, and fresh bodies are a rare commodity right now. When the last available corpse was turned to shreds by the berserker, the cat decided to use an illusion spell to make herself invisible to them. Now all that she needs is for her mercenaries to take care of Inoue Nori. Looking at her servants battling for their lives on the roof, they could certainly use her help, though Uchiha is paying them generously to kill some thugs. If they want their Nuyens, they'll have to earn it. Also screw that furless white chimpanzee that hangs with them. Whatever happens to the group, it's on him for kicking her. Many thoughts were passing through Dice's mind during this fight. She wondered what Cocktail just talked about before the fight. She pondered about her mission, and if she was truly meant to be an assassin. She also thought about, oh shit, fuck no, help me, as she was grabbed by the coked up Japanese Hulk Hogan. Cocktail, I will be arg. Pepper couldn't escape his grasp, and as she was lifted up into the air, she saw that the man was raising his knee, ready to break her spine like a particularly crunchy and bloody pretzel. In no condition to dodge, even less block or parry the move, she could only scream at the top of her lungs. But the back-breaking hit never connected. Right before the infiltrator's vertebrae made contact with her target's knee, his whole leg got torn apart. Wolfhound, right before the hit, managed to slice up Inoue Nori's limb with his Wolverine claws. Wolfhound, you alright, Dice? Dice, yeah, way more fright than harm. Missing a leg, one arm reduced to mincemeat due to Dice's monofilament whip, bleeding from everywhere and having his testicles crushed, Cocktail was running on fumes. The chemicals he injected into himself will kill him in the next minutes anyway. He couldn't move his body. His mechanical arm felt like it weighed a ton, and slowly the sense of abandon granted by his drugs was fading away. More and more he was aware in how much pain his body has been put into. Between two coughs of blood, the boss said this to the runners. Cocktail, I don't have much time left. Whatever you want, take it. Just finish me up. Quickly. I don't want to bleed out. Like a dog. Bite, still aching from the previous hit, work. Bastard. Hopefully you have the key to the safe. Cocktail, that I have. In my pocket. Short Fuse, intrigued, what's in the gas grenades you threw at your men? Cocktail, a recipe. Of my own. A mix of a special drug. To help against falling unconscious. And some K10. Short Fuse, pale, you got to be kidding me. Dice, confused, what's wrong? What's so bad with K10? Bite, grinning with no joy, well, that nasty thing turned people berserk. Dice, still confused, well, that I know, those yaks downstairs are still at it. Oh god, they just ripped one of those things apart. They're beating the remains with its own limbs. You apostrophe. Wolfhound, some are even trying to shoot us. Can't aim for Drek though. Bite, well, the thing is normally you inject it, but long exposure, say by gas grenades, have high chance to leave its victims permanently berserk. Dice, wait. You don't mean short fuse. It's too late for them. Pretty sad, even knowing our objective was to kill them. Bite. Yeah, now they're no better than animals. Weird they're not tearing each other apart though. Cocktail. In the mix I have added other substances. They won't kill others. Who smell like them? For now. Bite. Clever bastard. Short fuse. So what do we do now? Those, poor men don't seem to have had their fill of carnage. And they are looking right at us. Wolfhound. Plus MRS Johnson is already heading to her home. Short fuse. So, are we done here? Dice in her case wasn't done. In a way Nori had info she would desperately need, and she hoped to get them before he draws his final breath. Dice, what did you mean by another one? Or his antics? Tell me more about my master deadline's plans. Just to spite her master, the accuser would have told her everything that he knows, but unfortunately he lost too much blood already. He can also feel his brain swelling and boiling and he could barely stay conscious. Despite all that, he still managed to utter three words. Cocktail, Rockstar, Havana, please. Dice, Rockstar. He's on my list. Lorenzo Barone, aka Rockstar. He's an Italian shatterer that fell off the grid a decade ago. He was famous for playing in a band and recording his runs. Short fuse, guest celebrity finally caught up to him. Dice, so that means he's hiding in Havana. Oh yeah. I'm so close. Wolfhound, how many more you have? Dice, counting Rockstar, I only have like 4 dudes left. Bite, sarcastic, well good for you kid. Oh boy, I sure can't wait for you to explore the world and iced some random pricks. Don't forget to send us souvenirs. Wolfhound, we could help her, you know, instead of being a jerk about it. Plus don't you want some vacay at the beach? Bite. Not sure you've noticed, big guy, but albinos and beaches don't go hand in hand. So no. Short fuse. Well, I can't wait to visit this place, personally. Bite. Doubt you can even afford a ticket to economic, hobo. So why bother? Dice. We're shatteriners. We'll just do a job for it. Bite. God damn it. Wolfhound. Suadu. What do we do about them? The street samurai was pointing at the band of raving yaks under them. Each still in a state of absolute murderous rage. Some were rampaging through some old empty crates, while the ones who had firearms, and wasted all their bullets during the fight, were left swinging their guns at the air, foaming at the mouth and never breaking eye contact. Short fuse, we could wait a while. The drug's sure to come off soon, right? Dice vehemently nodded in agreement. Not desiring to face the men downstairs, but the Decker had another idea in mind. After looting the defeated leader, he used a comlink that he found and made a call for the police. Now why would a grade A asshole, a thrash of a human being and a professional douchebag, ever think of calling the authorities? While the answer is sure not to surprise you, his method might be. Bite. Hi. Hello sir. I've seen some punks sneaking in a warehouse. I'll send you the coordinates. Yeah, those teenagers have been playing loud music and tagging the buildings around here. Can you do something about it? Yes. Yes. Thank you very much. Yes. Yes. I knew I could count on you. Wolfhound. Bite. I agree it's better to leave it to the pigs than us, but why punks? Bite. With the most dickish of smiles. So they would send only one patrol. Just like Bite planned. One patrol vehicle from Lone Star Security Services arrived at the warehouse. The second the two officers exited the car, it was as if a hive mind took control of the berserkers. They all sprinted at the cops with guttural and animal-like noises. The poor bastards barely had the time to call for reinforcements and shoot once or twice before their limbs were ripped from their bodies in a gruesome fashion. The group profited from the momentary distraction to sneak away from their nest and rejoin their client at her old master's house. Needless to say, the dwarf and the elf were furious at the hacker for tricking the policeman like that. He himself said that the pigs don't deserve compassion, especially coming from a shatterer. The orc just didn't care. The cat was sitting next to the safe she had revealed hours ago. Not like a regular cat, mind you, but with a very human-like posture. Her two tails were balancing from left to right and her cold glowing eyes were following the group. She was also playing with the bodies of two rats that she reanimated. MRS Johnson, so you've finally arrived. You sure have taken your time. She then proceeded to have the rodents battle each other with rusty nails, Duel of the Fates style. Dice, sorry for that, we had questions to ask Inoue Nori before his demise. MRS Johnson, now that I'm thinking about it, you have knocked out those goons, but they got right back up. I asked of you to destroy them. One of the two rats then managed to stab the other in the chest. Despite the gaping wound, it was still standing. Bite, with evil glee. Don't worry about it, kitty. It's all taken care of right as we speak. I even suggest that you watch tomorrow's news. Appreciate our handiwork. MRS Johnson, you might be the rudest group of apes I've ever dealt with, but you did the task as asked. Shadowrunners, you deserve what my master stashed in this safe and may our paths never cross again. Dice, if I may ask, what would you do now? Do you intend to stay here? MRS Johnson, I plan to climb up in the world, and there's a front of the accusers that have a nice spot for me to give. Fortunately they won't have a say in the matter. The Bakaniko then exited the apartment with the rat by her side, one still having the nail going through its chest. Short Fuse remembered that he should have asked about the strange jellyfish spirit he saw, but it will likely not matter in the future. Inside the safe was the 20,000 New Yens as promised, as well as around 4,000 more in an assortment of drugs, like one dose of K10 that Wolfhound decided to keep in case he needs the edge in a future fight. Dice wanted to dump the illegal substances in a fire or sell them. Bite was on board for selling it, Short Fuse wanted to keep them, and use some for his own recreational activities. Wolfhound had to intervene by saying that if some random bozos start selling drugs out of the blue, it might tick off a dealer somewhere and bring us trouble for selling in his turf. The group decided to keep the drugs, but the dwarf can't have access to it. Well guys, hope you enjoy today's video. We are going to assume you have if you have stayed to the end. Consider subscribing and clicking the notification bell if you really enjoyed it to stay up to speed with any and all new videos. Also check out the links below to our shop for some fat ass titties and our sponsor Rural, and be sure to use a promo code at checkout so they know we sent you and you'll get 10% off. And until next time.